for this. Okay, then I'll share a file. Okay. Now, so the second part, as I said, right, it is dealing with the reciprocal interactions that are happening during the development of the kidney. Probably if you have gone through the previous video, you might have seen that the two tissues here, right, metanephrogenic mesenchymal and the ureteric bud. These are all the two tissues that are going to form. Okay, can you hear me? All of you are hearing it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, okay, this this interactions between the two tissues are what we are going to talk about. So, this particular one, right, this, what happens is, the both the tissues interact with each other, influence each other's development. For example, this tissue will going to develop into a mass of tissues, whereas it and induce the ureteric bud to branch. At the same time, this branch, right, the ureteric bud, branching will influence this particular mesenchymal tissue to become an epithelial tissue. Okay, that is what we'll be seeing in the next this particular lecture. You can see the formation of the ureteric bud development as well as the mesenchymal metanephrogenic mesenchymal that is forming and forming a ciliary structure here. So this particular mechanism of this two interacting with each other serves as a model for understanding how this particular development is going to happen. This is serving as a model for several organ development. For example, heart and other organ development has been understood by using this particular model. So, this development takes in 8 steps. So the first step is the formation of metanephrogenic mesenchymal cells. Okay, so you can see that this particular tissue we have seen, they are originally forming from the paraxial mesoderm that we have studied in the last class. Okay, then what happens is this particular tissue is have a unique fate or competence for that matter. The fate is like this particular tissue cannot develop into any other kind of tissue, only it will form nephrons and kidney related tissues. Even if it is induced by the other tissues, it will not form, you cannot induce this particular tissue to heart muscles or blood vessels or whatever it is, it will develop only into nephrogenic tissues. That is one unique thing about this particular tissue. The second one is, it is 3 genes that is regulating the formation. One is called as the FOXC, right, and FOXC1 and 2. This particular, so it is a kind of a negative regulator because we don't want all the tissues to develop into neurons. So what we are trying to do here is like this particular 2 proteins actually restrict the formation of this metanephrogenic mesenchymal to a specific location. So wherever there is these 2 proteins are expressed, you won't see the development of your metanephrogenic mesenchymal cells. So you can actually specify the location for the development. The second one is the kidney forming, that is the actual formation of nephrons, that will be taken care by the FOX11 genes. Then it also has to, we have seen that it has reciprocatively interact with the ureteric, but that will be taken care of by the WT1 gene. So these 3 genes are involved in the process of formation of metanephrogenic mesenchymal cells. The second step is the secretion of specific protein called as GDNF, right? This is a glial cell derived neuro factor. So what is nephro? So it's actually sorry, it's a nephrogenic factor. It will also plays a role in the neurogenesis. That's why they call it as a neurogenic factor. So you can see there are three systems here. The expression of the GDNF is regulated by the PAX2 as well as HOX11. So we have seen this. HOX11 maintains the formation of nephron. So this HOX11 activates the GDNF. GDNF later we'll see in turn induce the nephrogenesis. And again, the GDNF should not be expressed in all parts of the tissue. It has to be expressed only in a specific region. Right? You can see only a specific region expression of GDNF is observed. Okay. So this is to make sure that we have seen that, right?
There are in the posterior part.
Okay. Yes, yes. You can see that actually in your previous slides, we have seen three different nephrogenesis. One is the pronephrons and mesonephrons. Okay, so if you look at that, they are going to disintegrate. So you can see this receptor for this particular GDNF is the RET receptor. Okay, so what happens? This interactions helps the ureteric to branch. So you can see only in the tips of the ureteric buds, you can see the RET protein receptor where your GDNF is going to interact, and these interactions make this ureter to develop branches. Okay, so this is the step two. So the third step is the from the ureteric bud. The first two is from mesogenic, the other is from the ureteric bud. So the ureteric bud produces two proteins, FGF2 and BMP7. So we have seen these two proteins already. One is the fibroblast growth factor, the other one is the bone morphogenic protein. So this bone morphogenic protein has three modes of action, three functions actually. One is it inhibits the apoptosis. We have seen that if there is no induction, the mesenchymal cells will die. So it inhibits the apoptosis and it promotes the condensation of the mesenchymal cells. We have seen this, that particular mesenchymal cell has to go on forms a cap to the ureteric bud. So this is what you call as condensation. The third one is it maintains the synthesis of WT1. So WT1 makes the mesenchymal cell to develop into nephrons. This is the third step. So the fourth step is there is another set of factors called as lamina inducing factors, LIF. So these LIF actually are several proteins combined together. And these proteins actually makes the mesenchymal cells, right? Okay, to convert into epithelium. So we need nephrons or epithelial-like structures. You know, the mesenchymal cells are loose cells. That is kind of a mass of cells. The epithelium is a laminar structure. For this conversion, you can see that. So it produces two adhesive proteins. One is the E-cadherin. The other one is the syndicate. So this will make the mesenchymal factors to aggregate, whereas the other two protein, epithelial basal lamina containing type, collagen and laminin, they'll make them into epithelial layer. So what happens here? Now the proteins from the ureteric bud influences the mesenchymal cells to become a condensed structure. That is what you can observe here. You can see a loose structures will develop into a kind of aggregated structures. You can see a neat tube-like structure is formed from the mass of tissues. Okay. So the fourth step is the proteins involved here is the Wnt9 and Wnt6. Okay, this is produced from the ureteric bud. But this protein, Wnt4, is secreted in the mesenchymal cells. Once the mesenchymal cells aggregate and forms a lamina, they themselves secrete the protein called Wnt4. It will be like a autocrine factor that makes the mesenchymal cells to convert from epithelial structure to the other. Okay, And they have also identified one more protein called as limb homeodermine transcription factor. This, you can see, this protein is expressed only after the mesenchymal cells becomes an epithelial cells. Then it will be seen throughout the development of the nephron formation. That means that this particular limb protein will have an important role in development of the kidney. So then again, we'll go back to the mesenchymal cells. The first two is from your mesenchyma. The other three is from the ureteric bud. Then we go again to the mesenchymal cells. You can see that you have to create a branch in the ureteric bud. Okay. Tell me.
Sir, can you leave the meeting as open to all? Because many students are trying, but they are unable to enter.
Hello, participants. I just allowed everyone to come. 82 okay, participants you, are allowed now. Okay. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. What is this? This is what the problem, right? Okay, you can see that. So now what you do is the ureteric structure has to be branched. So imagine this is the ureteric structure. So you want this to develop into a branch like this, right? How you are going to do that? So what you have to do is you are going to allow the growth in this particular region and this region. All this region is, you are going to block the growth. So you block the growth here, allow the growth only in this direction so that it will create a branch here. From here again, you allow the growth here, allow the growth here, allow the growth here, but not here. So this is what you call as creation of branches. So by specifically allowing the cells to grow in one certain regions, you are going to create a branches. So this is done by two sets of proteins, push and pull proteins. So push proteins restrict the growth. So this, wherever these proteins are present, there will be a preservance of your extracellular matrix. So there is no growth. The other regions, the pull proteins, they allow the growth. Okay, that is the examples for this is the GDNF. The restriction is going to be the TGF beta 1. Similar kind of proteins you can observe. So this kind of allowing proteins that will allow the extracellular matrix to get degraded, allows the branching to happen. When the lamina structure, the basal lamina is thick, so there is no branching. So this is how the ureteric bud forms branches. Then the nephrons are going to develop. So those cells that condensate around the ureteric buds, covers the tips of the ureteric buds, actually five cells will develop rapidly into neurons. The rest of the cells will develop into the other structures. So five cells form the tubular condensate. The next slide, we'll see the developed kidney structure is going to be okay. The developed structure is going to be involved. You can see that. So already it is the early stage of your embryo. You can see the mesonephrons are there. This is what we are talking about. The mesenchymal cells and the ureteric bud. So we know that as the growth progresses, this will become non-existent. only this tube, right, this Wolfian duct is going to retain. Rest of the nephrons are going to get destroyed. Okay. So here is what we are talking about. The mesenchymal tails and the ureteric buds are going to interact with each other. So after certain time, you can see the complete loss of your mesonephrons. You can see the development of the kidney. So also observe two things. You can see that initially there is no differentiation between the your digestive tract and the urogenital tract. You can see they are attached together. And this particular region is called as the cloaca. It is retained in the birds, it is retained. Okay, animal, in the birds you can see only the cloaca. So the cloaca is the Latin word for sewer. So sewer, you know that it is a collecting waste tissues. Now what happens? In the developed males, this is a male urogenital system, you can see the septum that actually separates the urogenital tract from the digestive tract. So this is going to be the pelvic region. This is going to be the rectum. So rectum is a digestive tract. So here you have the bladder as well as the genital systems. Okay. You can see that Wolfian duct that is carrying the semen, right, is retained here. That will go and open in this near to the genitals. Also, the kidney that is going to filter your urine is going to open at the genital, and the digestive system and the urogenital system are separated. And this is the space, the septum that separates the urogenital system from the digestive tract. So this is what you have to understand. The next development is the development of glomerulus and other complicated structures, which is not in your syllabus. You have a basic development of kidney tissue and the how the reciprocal interactions between the kidney tissue and the other two tissues are happening. So far, we have covered everything in the kidney development. And probably we can open the session for the discussion. If you have any questions, you can ask now. I unmute one. You can, somebody can message me. If you have a doubt, I'll unmute them and I'll find. So you, if you want to talk, you can unmute your phone and talk to me. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
There are 3 minutes. So if you have any doubts, I would like to clarify that one.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Can you send the recording in the Google Classroom, because
I recorded it, but I'll see whether it is okay. I'll send it, or I'll send a narrative PPT to you in the Google Classroom. Yeah.
Thanks.
Anything else?
No, sir.
Anyone else? Anybody else?
So I have a question regarding the test that we have this weekend.
Yeah.
Sir, will it only include the kidney section, or do we also have to do the heart?
Neurulation.
Okay, only neurulation.
Yeah, neurulation and kidney development, both.
Both of them. Okay.
Yeah, neurulation. I dealt that in the class itself, right? Regular class itself. So also the PPTs are there, so you can do that.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, Agila and others, why your people are joining late? No, the meeting is originally scheduled on 10 o'clock. If you are going to join at 10:30, that doesn't look nice, right? Agila?
Sir, actually we used the link, but we were not able to join.
Now you, it's okay now. Now you know how to join, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay then. Anything regarding to the PPTs that I have sent or anything regarding to the test is going to be few MCQs and two short answer questions. Don't worry about the weightage or the marks that is going to be awarded for that, because most of the time you are going to be lenient. So only thing is that you make sure that you are following those classes and just keep a tab on it, right? So we also want to know how many people are engaging, all these other things, okay? Hello.
Sir, what can I ask one question?
Yeah, who is this?
Sir, Devuti here.
Yeah, tell me, Devuti.
How are we going to give the test? Like we have to upload the answers.
You go through the Google Classroom. There will be a test component. You have to answer it online there itself.
Okay.
There's going to be a time limit, say 10 minutes. So within the 10 minutes, you answer all the questions and that's it.
Sir, will it be similar to how we give our assignment in NPTEL? Like we select the answers and submit?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Anything else?
Sir, may I ask you something? Working.
Which one? Which video, Roshan?
Sir, the part one video, sir. You sent just 1 hour back.
Yeah, that accidentally I just erased the previous video. I'll just see what is happening. I'll upload all the videos again afresh. No issue.
Okay.
So what about the assignment?
Yeah, assignment topics you'll give, it will be at the end of the next month, right?
So the next week probably we'll give you the topic. So you write that down and submit it. That we'll evaluate in the May. In the May month, we will give you another assignment that you can submit when you come back to the class.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Anything else, ma'am? So
Hello.
Yeah, tell me, ma'am.
Hello, who is this?
Hello, sir. Hariharan here, sir.
Yeah, tell me, Hari.
Sir, about the assignment only. It has already been posted that we have to write an assignment based on insect metamorphosis or amphibian metamorphosis.
Yeah, that is what we have originally planned. I'll discuss with Devi, ma'am, and probably I'll confirm it once.
Yes, sir, because if it is insect, does it mean Drosophila in particular or just the general?
No, that's a common one. Common.
Okay, sir. Okay.
You can take it. Okay, so since I have a meeting, another meeting at 10:45, I'll end this meeting. If you have anything to ask, you can ask me now. 2 minutes.
Sir, how many pages should it be? Not pages and all are not important. How you are preparing and the topic is okay.
There is no specific page restriction. But it should be good, that's it. To be evaluated, you know how to write, how much to write, right?
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Okay, ma, I'll finish this meeting, okay? Anything else? Okay, thank you very much for your attention. Next time, please be on time, right? You are still, some people are joining. Please be on time. Yeah, I understand. I understand technical issues. We'll do that later. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.